Is the Surface Go 2 right for you? That's a really interesting question, because what we have here is a really great 2-in-1 laptop. And if all you have is a desktop computer or an old laptop, then this could be a great upgrade for you. Of course, it's not a high performance machine. I mean, Microsoft doesn't even advertise it for those purposes. They have the Surface Pro. But if all you do is productivity and browse the web, then this could be exactly what you're looking for. Now, on my channel, I already posted a lot of Surface Go 2 coverage showing you what it could do and different scenarios it could be great in. This video is my own personal opinion, you know, it's very editorial, and it's up to you to take all that knowledge and then decide for yourself whether or not you think you should purchase it. So I've been using this for nearly a month now, so it's time to give it back, and you know, I'm going to really miss using it. I think it's a great device for a lot of people, but what's hesitating me from recommending this to everyone is that I feel like if you already own a tablet, like an iPad or a Kindle Fire, you're probably gonna choose a laptop over this. In my previous coverage, I mentioned how much I like the screen, the webcam, and the speakers, and all that remains true. The real issue is actually just Windows 10 in tablet mode. Now listen, if you don't have anything and you want to buy one device that can do both, I think you could be very happy with the Surface Go 2, and I think you'd learn the quirks of using Windows 10 in tablet mode. But if you already own a tablet and you're used to that tablet experience, Windows 10 in tablet mode will not be as good. So I was going to do another video about gaming and intense tasks on the Surface Go 2, but I'm not a huge gamer, so I'm just going to do it here instead. Look, this will not do AAA games. It's not what it's designed for. It even struggled playing House Flipper. But games like The Sims 4 ran fantastic on it, and so did Unity games like Lara Croft Go. They worked great, and as did other casual games. But, you know, another thing you could use this for is if you had a gaming computer and you wanted to play a game in another room on your Surface Go 2, you can use Steam Play and stream it, and that could be a great solution if that's something you want to do. I also ran Photoshop on the Surface Go 2, and I just about did the thumbnail. Now look, it's not the fastest thing ever, you know, it struggled loading Canon RAW images, and using Photoshop itself wasn't very fast. But, you know, if you're doing occasional photo editing, you could probably use this. But look, this is like a professional tablet for productivity. You know, if you're in business, law, finance, the medical field, this is why you want it. This is not a creative professional tablet. For those tasks, you definitely want an iPad or an iPad Pro. Now, as an update from my previous video, it appears the issue I had with the USB-C monitor fixed itself. I installed the latest Windows 10 May update, the 2004 edition, and it runs absolutely great now with the USB-C monitor. So I can totally recommend that setup of connecting it to a USB-C monitor and, you know, with charging the Surface Go 2 and you having a bigger screen. It worked absolutely fantastic. Now, a real potential hurdle for the Surface Go 2 is its screen and keyboard. As I said before, because I don't have the largest hands, it actually worked fine for me. But I mean, if you're doing like essays from start to finish and you want to do it on this alone, I'd consider getting a mouse keyboard for it. I mean, the Surface Go 2 really belongs in an ecosystem of you either plugging it into a dock, like a USB-C monitor, and having that kind of setup when you're at home, or you already have another computer, like a desktop. So I had to re-record this because my camera died, and I also noticed I had a ton of lint on my top, which I really apologize for. But back to the review, I want to talk about productivity on the Surface Go 2. What I really like about the Surface Go 2 is that you can be productive on it. I mean, it runs full Windows. And unless you're doing intense tasks, I think this could be perfect for a lot of people. Because as I said before, there's a lot of people out there who just want to do those like regular computing tasks, but they still want a great screen and, you know, great sound and a great webcam. And traditionally that meant you'd have to buy something like a MacBook Air, and for like €1,300 that would come with like a quad-core processor, and those things would be overkill for that person, but because they still wanted a great laptop, that's what they bought. Whereas they can now get this at basically half the price, and the screen is 400 nits of brightness, which is the same as a MacBook Air. It has one of the best sound systems I've ever heard in a PC laptop. PC laptops typically have terrible sound. And yeah, it just has all those premium components that make a great laptop, even if it doesn't have the fastest chip. But I really appreciate Microsoft doing that, because if you want faster chips, they have the Surface Pro and they have the Surface Book. I think on YouTube especially, there can be an idea that basically everybody's a video editor or a gamer, where in real life that's not exactly true. There's a lot of people who just have like regular computing needs. And if you're that type of person who just wants a really ultra portable, you know, 2-in-1 tablet laptop that gets the job done, I think you could be very happy with the Surface Go 2. But as long as I said before, you do not already own a tablet. So those are my thoughts. I think Microsoft did a great job on the Surface Go 2. If I had influence, I'd give this an Editor's Choice Award, but I don't. But it kind of just made me really excited about the future of ultra portable computing and laptops and tablets and the idea of one computer being everything for you. But as much as I am an early adopter, you know, it's just a tiny bit too early for me right now. So those are my personal thoughts on the Surface Go 2. I have a ton of Surface Go 2 coverage on my channel, nearly half an hour's worth, including this video. So you can go to my channel and check those videos out if you want to. But also leave a comment below, now that you've seen the review, if it's helped you make a decision if you're gonna buy one of these or not. I'm really curious to hear your thoughts. Also, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to stay tuned for future technology videos, you know, for future products that get as much coverage as this, if that's the sort of thing you're into. You can give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. But I also just kind of want to say, I'm really in full solidarity with the protesters in the United States right now. So on that note, just stay safe and stay well. Try to keep your distance if you're protesting, because, you know, a lot of people in the world are still sick. But other than that, I hope you guys stay safe, and I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye.